It's official now. You're crazy. You are out of your fucking mind.
Maybe. Probably.
But I did it, and it's too late to undo it. Benny?
You kidding me?
What?
First, you don't come back to New York, and you basically tell me that you'd rather be a drunk than be with me. And now you pull this crap? No, you can fucking well go alone.
Benny.
Don't call me anymore.
So this was a process. One of my first changings of my face, so bear with me. Usually I'm doing some special effects and face paint looks, but changing your actual facial appearance while maintaining a somewhat human exterior is really hard. First of all, Anya Taylor has such an incredibly unique facial shape. The features of that which I want to stay mostly original to my face are my lips, so I scrub them out, which means I just use a lip scrub, as they will be a focal point, and put a mask on them, a lip mask specifically, because a scrub will basically just be murderous otherwise. My face was not having a good time this day, and she is essentially flawless, or so it seems. So I needed to both lighten my complexion slightly to match her fair skin and hide some of these blemishes. Trust the process is all I have to say to this. Then went straight for the brows. Hers are probably the most similar of any facial structure that she has to me besides my lip, or my bottom lip I suppose, so I did my regular brow routine for this portion of the face. Then went back over any places that I felt needed a little bit more coverage in the concealer department, powdered everything up, or down I guess. Then it was time for contour. I went pretty hard in my cheek area, as you can probably tell Anya has very pronounced cheeks. And I blended out slightly so it was both very exaggerated but it flows nicely into the rest of my face, as well as adding definition to my chin on the bridge of my nose between my eyes, carrying it down while intermittently tapping with my finger to disperse it more evenly, and giving me a somewhat button style of nose by taking that same contour around the end and underneath as well. Later around the nostrils and around my Cupid's bow. It isn't a huge difference, but for a first try, I definitely did notice a change. Next up, blush. I used a peachy pink tone on my upper cheek. And top them with a little bit of an almost glittery white eyeshadow to both add a little bit more of a lightness to my skin and a highlight at the same time. I've added this white shadow everywhere else where I'd previously placed a contour, as wherever there is a shadow, there is always light. And that is your inspirational quote of the day. Eye time. Priming that up using a gray eyeshadow as my transition shade, going over the top with a light brown beige tone. Away from under my eyes specifically, because these two will not be connected. They will be very similar, but they are not going to be connected. Using a black liner for, again, a slight wing. To open up my eyes a little bit more though, I could have used a white liner, but I opted for a pink instead to give a more subtle effect because she does have quite big eyes, and I mean, I think I have somewhat big eyes, so I'm not really sure. In comparison, no. Then I used the same brownish beige eyeshadow underneath my eye and made a slight wing on that too, again without connecting it at all, adding a coat of mascara. And then finally we've made it to the lips, which I am carving out with an angled brush and a lip and cheek tint. First, she has a very pointed upper lip that tapers off to the edges fairly fast, and a similar bottom lip to mine, minus the edges. They seem to almost curve more into themselves, and then I'm adding a lighter and more vibrant, almost like a cranberry shade over top. I added a bit too much to the bottom size, which was easily fixable with that same concealer that I had used before. Then it is time to get fancy. I'm a little obsessed with the way fashion is from the 50s to the 60s, so I already had a similar dress to hers, well, Beth's, from another costume. Oddly enough, similar to Wednesday Addams. That's why I already had the dress. Then to finish the look off, a shoulder-length orange wig and a bunch of legally obtained booze and fake pills that are literally just quick-release Advil gel capsules that I happen to have that look kind of similar to who's taking the movie, which are tranquilizers, obviously, but they're kind of a similar shape and color. That is it for today's video. I do hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you next one. Happy Halloween!